Mystery behind meeting each other life after life.
Marriage is a major bondage. It is like being locked up as cattle in a carriage. It is best not to be trapped in that situation. But if you happen to get married, it is in your best interest to settle all your accounts of the relationship with equanimity. If not, then, in the end, get out after having tasted its fruits. In reality, the soul is not anyone's husband or wife, man or son. It is only karma that are unfolding and accounts that are being settled. The soul remains unchanged in all this. The soul is the soul, and the absolute self is absolute. It is your belief that she is your wife. Who teaches these birds how to weave such beautiful nests? You will not have to put too much effort in how to run your daily life. Yes, there is some effort required in acquiring knowledge of the self. However, there is no need to do anything to run this world. Of all the living things, only humans think that they are too smart. Do these animals not have spouses? Do they have to get their children married? It is only these humans who end up having wife and children. Only the human beings are so caught up with marriages. Even these cows and buffaloes have marriages. They too have children. But is there such a thing as a husband or boss there? They too become fathers-in-law and mothers-in-law. But do they organize things like these intelligent people? Do they ever say, "I am her father-in-law"? Despite this, their lives are just like ours. They too breastfeed their young and lick their calves, don't they? You are a pure soul and your interactions with the world should be superficial. You have to remain in the home department, that is your real self, and remain superficial in the foreign department, that is your relative self. Superficial means not having tendencies to get involved or engrossed in thought, speech, and acts. Live your life as if you are in a drama, but this drama has to be acted out very precisely. At the time of profit, you have to laugh in this drama, and at the time of losses, you have to cry. You have to accurately portray the emotions in the drama. You have to act out the part, but do not become involved internally. You have to maintain casual acquaintances and connections only. Have you not heard people say, "My relationship with this gentleman is casual"? That is the kind of relationship you have to keep with the whole world. He who knows how to maintain this kind of relationship becomes a jnani. You have to keep a similar relationship even with your body. I have that kind of a relationship with everyone, but people still tell me, "You keep a very good relationship with us." I go through the motion of all the worldly interactions while remaining as the self.
Is it possible that a husband's success is because of his wife's good karma? Don't people say that it is because of the wife's good karma that the family has wealth and prosperity? Is that true?
People say those things to keep an abusive husband in check. If a man abuses his wife, then people around will tell him, "Just look at the good fortune of your wife. Why are you abusing her? You are able to eat because of her good karma." That is how everything got started. Each living being eats due to its own karma. Do you understand? However, you have to say these things because only then will things move along. Everyone enjoys the fruits of their own merit karma, and the suffering they have to endure is also due to their own bad karma. In reality, no living being ever interferes with another living being. There is absolutely no interference of any kind whatsoever.
If a man does some charitable work and his wife supports this, do both of them reap the benefits of the good deeds?
Of course, the person who carries out the task, the one who encourages him to do so, and the person who supports that task are all collectively involved, and therefore they will all reap the benefits of the good deed. If someone tells you, "Do this because it is a worthwhile task," and you follow his advice, you become the doer. He becomes the one to encourage the task. And if your wife does not object to it, she becomes the supporter. All three will bind karma. The doer will reap 50% of the benefits, and the remaining 50% will be distributed between the one who encouraged the task and the one who supported it.
What should one do to be free from the karmic relations created from past life?
You end up living with a person because of your past life account. If you simply do not like living with the person you are married to, you have no choice. This is your account and you cannot escape it. So then, what should you do? You should keep relations with that person on the outside, but from within, you should do pratikraman for them because your current predicament is a result of your atikraman from your past life. Atikraman, that is, causes transgression of attachment or abhorrence through the mind, speech or actions. What were the causes? The causes were acts of transgression against that person in your previous life, the result of which you are now experiencing. Therefore, if you do pratikraman for him, you will lighten the load. Keep doing pratikraman internally and keep asking for forgiveness from his soul. Then, you will be able to bring an end to your misery. Do your pratikraman through any god and keep that god as your witness. Then everything will be cleared. Otherwise, what will happen? If you keep looking at him with scorn and you keep blaming him, contempt will set in and you will come to hate him. Feelings of hate and contempt will lead to feelings of aversion and fear. When you feel contempt for a person, you will also fear that person. The moment you see that person, you feel afraid. Recognize this as a consequence of inner contempt. In order to be free from contempt, repeatedly keep asking for forgiveness from the pure soul of that person you have contempt for. This contempt will stop in 2 days. Acknowledge your faults and all wrongdoing against that person. Understand that your current predicament is the result of your own past errors. Ask the Lord within him for forgiveness for all the hurt you have caused him. Then everything will be washed away.
If we want to follow the path of religion, then we have to renounce our home and the world. This may be good for our religious progress, but it hurts the people at home. Is it not selfish to renounce the life at home for one's own religious benefit?
First, you will have to fulfill your obligations and responsibilities towards your family. If you make them happy, then they will be happy to let you go without any reservations. However, do not do anything that would hurt them because you cannot breach that agreement.
Dada, I feel like leaving this material world. What should I do?
Do you admit that there was a day when you had a desire to be part of this material world?
At that time, I did not have this gnan. Now I do. It makes all the difference.
Yes, it does make a difference. But now that you have entered into it, you have to find a way out. However, you cannot just run away from it.
असीम जय जयकार हो
दादा भगवान ना असीम जय जयकार हो
दादा भगवान ना असीम जय जयकार हो
दादा भगवान ना असीम जय जयकार
हो You will not meet the same partner life after life.
When one partner's karmic account is paid off, they pass on to another life. When that occurs, are we likely to meet that individual again? If that individual has created an account with us, are we likely to meet them again in another life?
If an account is bound with them, you will meet them again. If you forget the world by just looking at the person, then the karmic bond has already been created. My one and only son, I cannot live without him. So what will you do when you have to go to the cemetery? That is, die. Never speak that way. Do not say, he is my one and only son. When the time comes to go, he will go. A crematorium and cemetery are the businesses of this world. People take birth, but death is inevitable.
Precious time is passing away, Dada.
Death is inevitable. You are going to die even as you insist that she is yours. Really, she is not yours. And if she goes early, then you have to sit alone. If she really was yours, you both would depart together, would you not? At times, a rare woman becomes a sati, that is, one who voluntarily dies on the husband's funeral pyre with her husband. But even then, what path will she take and what path will he take? Each individual's future life form is dependent upon his karmic account. Some will be born again as humans, while some will go into the animal kingdom. Some will become celestials. Asati will claim, if I die with him, I will be born with him. However, that does not happen. That is all foolishness. Really, there is no such thing as a husband and wife. All these unions are arrangements made by society.
If there are no quarrels in a marriage, then will a husband and wife be able to live together again in the next life?
In this very life, there is no harmony together. Couples divorce each other in this very life. So why are you even talking about the coming life? There is no such love at all. Those who are likely to be together in the next life are couples that have harmony in this current life. They have a lot of love in their life. They do not see any faults in each other at all. If either one of them makes a mistake, the other will not see it as such. This is the kind of love that exists between the two.
If their present life is filled with such love, then will the same people come together in their next life?
Yes, they can. Certain lives are such that they will. If they have never quarreled in their entire life, then they will come together again.